It's East Tennessee State against Oklahoma. For the Buccaneers, a lineup that features three sophomores and two freshmen. The Sooners, a much more veteran club. We get set for the opening tip. It is Dennis against King, and we are just about underway from Memorial Gym. It takes over 15,000. The opening tip controlled by Keith Jennings, but everybody calls him Mr. He's only 5'7". Mr. Jennings against Mookie Blaylock.
Right off the start, he got an idea of the quickness of Mookie Blaylock to try to make a spin move and ran right into Mookie.
First shot of the ball game from Calford. Calford, who also plays baseball and has a professional contract with the Phillies, puts East Tennessee State on top.
Great way for the Buccaneers to start off. Let's get the first shot down, get some confidence, but they'll have their problems with this guy inside, Stacey King, particularly to try to cover him man on man.
Immediately, King gets the Sooners even. We played less than a minute in Nashville. Good move on the side using the baseline for his second basket is Calford, the freshman from Castlewood, Virginia.
He's a tremendous athlete. He does a lot of things. And this team has a lot of speed to match up with Oklahoma, always knowing there's a speed team.
I'm not sure anybody can match up with that guy. Davis with a follow, a foul called inside. Jody Sylvester whistles the first foul of the afternoon.
Watch the action here. Here's Stacey King, Big A player of the year, swings that left-hand hook. This time doesn't get it down. But William Davis, coming off a great Big A tournament performance, goes up strong for the rebound, gets fouled. Davis, a good offensive rebound.
A junior college transfer, one of six that the Sooners have in their top 12 players. Billy Cubs from the junior college ranks himself.
That's right. Davis led Hutchinson Community College to the 88th National Junior College Championship. So, excellent addition to the Sooner team.
Davis with a pair at the line. The game is even at four. We're just inside the 19-minute mark. Mr. Jennings outside, feeds it to Alvin West. West looks inside. They try to go inside. First foul of the game on Stacey King.
Get an idea who the crowd's going to be for here at Vanderbilt, always for the underdog. There's King coming over the top. Just caught going over the top of Greg Dennis. Dennis doing a nice job of moving with the ball and keeping King away.
Jennings inside to Dennis, moves it back outside. Does not take the three-pointer, hits the two. Jennings.
Jennings will show you the ball a lot like that pump fake. He basically would like to drive first, take the shot outside second. You got to have to stay down.
Inside to Davis, stripped away, but Davis gets it back, takes the shot, bending off. Rebound to Dennis. Back come the Buccaneers, up by two in the early going.
Buccaneers are running ball club, and Les Robbins says, we can't run with this ball club. They'll probably come off of that and play a little bit more half court.
Oklahoma with the rebound. On the break, it's King. Stacey King's second basket. You saw the three-point attempt by Dennis. That's not unusual. He has hit 11.
Well, he can do it all inside, as you said, outside. Come a long ways for a sophomore.
We are tied at six with 17:56. Jennings hangs, bends off, rebound King. Back come the Sooners as they work it ahead to Terrence Mullins. Again, Davis gets it inside. Bobbles it, has it blocked and deflected. Knocked away, touch left by Oklahoma, and East Tennessee will have it. The Buccaneers in blue, what a tremendous job by their head coach Les Robinson, now in his fourth year after spending 11 years at the Citadel. 17:30 to play first half in Nashville. Winner here plays Louisiana Tech, a winner earlier today over LaSalle. Dennis outside, King is with him. Now Jennings at the top of the circle. Back it goes to Dennis, off the lane, works his way in, has to reverse it. A three-pointer is good by Alvin West. His 61st of the year.
And this is a three-point shooting ball club. They've put up almost 500 this year, shooting about 41%, a little bit better than 41.
Won't go. Rebound Dennis. A three-point lead for the Buccaneers, and East Tennessee State has the basketball. Another three. Yes.
Well, they got this place on fire. You let a team like this, the 16th seed, East Tennessee State, in this ball game, they'll be tough. The more confidence they're going to get.
Blaylock penetrates. Doesn't get the roll underneath. It goes to Dennis. To Jennings. Here's the third straight three-point attempt, and this one is short by Alvin West. At the other end, Mullen lays it up and in.
Good crossover step and dribble that time by Mullen. Getting the start today, did not start last ball game at the Big 8 tournament. He's not shooting well, only 5 for 20 in that Big 8 tournament, three ball game.
Of course, that's true of the entire club.
That's right. Shooting 41.7% as a team coming out of that Big 8 tournament last three games.
Palford with a jumper. An off-balance jumper, and Dennis gets it back. Up, bending off. Rebounded underneath by Oklahoma. Mullins has it. He'll kick it to Davis. Now Mookie Blaylock. Blaylock, what he has done in 2 years at Oklahoma, just tremendous. Inside they go to Davis. He works his way in the lane, bending off. Tipped out on the court now. And the first held ball. Possession arrow will favor Billy Tubbs' team. Billy Tubbs, a tremendous job at Oklahoma also. 228 wins in 9 years, 7 straight NCAA appearances, 4 Big 8 championships, 4 times coach of the year. What can you say?
Not much more than that. Big 8 coach of the year now 2 years in a row.
He practiced during the week coaching from the end zone because that's where the benches are in this building. They are in the end zone. King taken away from him. Halford picked up the steal. And it's Halford for the basket.
Well, Mullins made a mistake right there. He went up and left his feet up in the air and left the man completely wide open on the kickback pass.
And it was Major Gear into the lineup who completed that pass. King's baseline jumper good. Stacy with 6 points in the early going. 14-10, East Tennessee State leading.
And when you start to get in trouble, that's the man they're going to go to, Stacy King.
This is Gear, a good three-point shooter. Halford off to a good start. From the corner, Jennings against Blaylock. They bring it back out. The other substitution is Chad Keller, number 35 in the lineup. The foul is on Blaylock. So Mookie commits the personal foul. Mookie Blaylock's real name is Darren Blaylock. Exactly 15 minutes left in the first half. We have a timeout here on the court in Nashville, Tennessee. The Buccaneers have the early lead, 14-10 over Oklahoma.
Well, the Sooners can run, but so can East Tennessee State. Here you see Stacy King coming in right there, gets it stripped away. This is Telford, a great athlete, comes down, gets it in the ball to the middle right there, and then a great pass back from Garrett to Telford, and he lays it up for two. Watch the pass inside. Loses control right here. Blaylock gets a hold of it, and then Mullins goes up to protect as he goes out of bounds, but a good kickback pass to Telford.
And we return to live action. Jennings gets it low inside to Keller. Keller moves it back out now. This is Major Gear. They swing it in the corner. Jennings looks inside to Keller. Keller picking it up for Dennis right now. They want to rest him and keep him as strong as possible throughout the game.
Well, they've played 8 kids a lot during the year. Gear is in and out, started 20 times. He's also a good three-point shooter.
Gear with some penetration. Power move inside, partially blocked, tip up, and just missed King with a rebound. Good strong effort that time by Marty Story, a transfer from Clemson where he was a football player. He's a freshman.
This guy has really been coming off the bench and playing well. Bell, he made the block on the other end. Interesting thing about Bell, he's blocked only 13 shots less than Stacy King, but he's played 700 minutes less, John.
Foul called inside against Oklahoma. Mike Bell.
Good check out. Look at the blue shirts. Got all white guys behind him there. White shirts behind.
So it's the third team foul. The first on Bell into the lineup. They beat the Oklahoma pressure. Jennings now who runs the offense. Here's Dennis from the sideline. His first basket, he averages 17 a game.
He shoots almost 52% from the field. He can go out and stroke it from that range.
A 6-point lead matching their biggest of the first half. Bell gets it up, thought he drew the foul, he did not. Instead, the rebound goes to Talford. This is Jennings now. Dennis from the side, it's going to be way short. Loose underneath, but on the end line, East Tennessee State will give it back to Oklahoma. The Sooners have it for Coach Billy Tubbs. He was asked numerous times which Oklahoma team was going to show up during the news conferences yesterday, and Tubbs was a little irritated by it.
Well, they definitely haven't been playing Sooner basketball, I'd say, for the last 5 to 7 ball games.
Bell using the glass, but doesn't get the roll. They go to the court in the scramble. This time the possession arrow favors the Buccaneers. Good hustle on the part of Major Gear. And checking back into the lineup once again is Alvin West, who had a couple of early three-pointers. We mentioned this is the first time they've played. However, last year Oklahoma started its NCAA tournament charge against, again, the Southern Conference champion, and again in the Southeastern Regional.
He said Gear can shoot the three-pointer. He's shooting 43% on the year. He's made 64 of 150.
And the lead grows to 9. King along the baseline, uses the glass and lays it home. He's so smooth. 8 points for Stacey King. Two fouls on Mookie Blaylock.
Mookie still the country's leader in steals with 122. Watch him right here. Tries to get position at that time, cannot quite get there in time. Alvin West bringing the ball down for the Buccaneers.
Henry checks into the lineup. Skeeter Henry, another junior college transfer. He's from Midland Junior College.
Started 13 ball games this year, twice started in the Big 8 tournament. Been playing well late in the season.
Keller outside, and they kick it in the corner to Jennings. Billy Tubbs has used more different people this year than he did last year.
Yes, for the last couple of years, he's been pretty much on a set lineup. As you said, he's got people in.
The miss of the three by West. He made two. Now he's missed two. Intercepted by Jennings, but no place to go. Mr. Jennings was on his way out of bounds. Tried to save it, couldn't, but they love it here in Tennessee.
And he almost got, he leads the conference right here in steals with 66. And as you said, could not quite control the basketball.
Now they get the turnover. But Jennings has it. Does not like the numbers, so they'll reset. Now he penetrates, gives it up from the side. That's a two-pointer way short, and King is there to clear the air ball. He's fouled by Jennings. First foul on Jennings.
Brilliant little playmaker right there. Only a sophomore. He's averaged 6.5 assists for the year, a total of 195.
East Tennessee State University, coached by Les Robinson, located in Johnson City, Tennessee. And back into the lineup comes the freshman, Marty Story, number 34. Jennings will get a rest. Last time they played in this building was in the NIT, 1983, losing to Vanderbilt. And this is an unusual gym. There are no fewer than 9 scoreboards. The benches are in the end zone. Turnaround jumper short, rebound by Story. Now Major Gear, who has one of the 3 three-pointers.
So far, the Buccaneers doing a good job of sealing off and keeping the Sooners from getting more than one shot most of the time.
Gear hanging, can't hit. Tipped back, and Story has it.
Story, a real physical guard, 6'3", 195 pounds.
Skeeter Henry almost makes the interception. The ball goes out of bounds. You can see the scores table is at about, oh, your line of sight is about the ankle. You can see the benches at the end, so it's a little different view for the coaches. Some of them don't seem to mind it. Some are a little worried about it, I think.
Billy Tubbs is one that says, hey, I was down there during practice yesterday. Checked it out. He said, I could see a lot of things from the end of the court that I can't see from the side.
Dennis with a basket. He has 2 baskets in the game, and the lead is back to 9, matching the biggest of the first half with 11-11 to play. It's King along the baseline. This time, no place to go. Henry for 3. Short. Long lead to Dennis. Can he hang on to it? Yes, he gets it.
Good job by Dennis right there. Get himself under control. 6-11. Great job right there. He could take it up for the easy layup.
The basket will count. And a foul called on Dennis. So a good job that time by Andre Wiley. They call him the creator, and he created something there.
Well, here we see the long rebound coming out and a quick outlet pass. Here's Dennis go down. There's where he does the good job getting himself under control and putting it back off the glass.
Here is Mr. Jennings back into the lineup from Culpeper, Virginia. And the University of Virginia showed some interest in him. And matter of fact, one of their assistants kind of helped steer him toward East Tennessee State University, and he's very happy there. The Buccaneers are happy too. Wiley to the line. Tip try no good, still trying to tip it up. Finally knocked away.
Smart play.
Tip
Little guy Jennings that time way up in the air and then just kicked it back off an Oklahoma player and saved a possession.
23-14. Three straight misses from three-point range for West. It's knocked away inside, and here come the Sooners. Mookie Blaylock, he's got Mullins with him, tries to spin away, and it's an offensive foul. That's three on Mookie Blaylock.
That turnaround is fair play early in the ball game. It was Blaylock that stuffed Jennings on a spin move. Here comes Blaylock, extremely quick. So is Mister right here. Good position, and Jennings just sitting there waiting, had his feet planted, good position.
So Mookie will have to sit for a while. 10:30 to play in the first half. And Blaylock sits down. So we'll see what happens. The lead is 9. That's as big as it has been.
Well, the production from Blaylock has not been much over the last several ball games offensively, particularly.
He has not scored so far this afternoon. Jennings gets some penetration. Now from the side, it's Dennis. He misses everything. Again.
Yeah, he does it.
Mr. Jennings saves it for East Tennessee State.
Great hustle by the little guy, probably the shortest kid playing in the NCAA tournament. Goes up high, watch him take a look, trying to find a teammate, can't, bounces it off the Oklahoma player.
So a new 45 on the clock. We're inside 10 minutes remaining first half. Dennis comes to help out. They leave him alone and he shoots. He misses it, gets it back. He'll take it in. He's got the lane this time. 8 points for Greg Dennis.
No checkoff there after the shot. Bob Dennis just to come in, get the offensive rebound with a putback.
Now the lead is 11. Good baseline move that time by Terrence Mullins, and he draws the foul.
Good look at Mullins right there, named to the Big 8 first team all-academic team. Been struggling with the shooting, only 41% from the field this year. There's Mullins on the drive, takes it up. Story comes in there, Dennis, they all go after him. Mullins draws the foul.
And the foul was charged to Marty Story, the freshman from Greenville, Tennessee, his second. Mullins only a 62% shooter at the line. Gets the roll that time. 3 points for the sophomore from San Francisco. Career high for him, 27 points.
Talked about the Sooners shooting. They've scored 100, had 17 100-point games this year, but in the last 10, they've only averaged 92, and then three in the tournament, they averaged just about 86 points. So their offensive production really fallen off.
4 points now for Mullins. It's East Tennessee State 25, Oklahoma 15. We'll be back after this. We would like your opinion. What's your opinion?
I like the line right where it is right now. I think it's added a lot to the game, and it's a factor in the game. If you push it out there farther than what it is, I don't think the coach are going to shoot it as much. And
three,
it opens up
pointers,
the middle inside.
3 3-pointers in this ball game. Jennings doesn't shoot. Calford from the side. He has 8 points. Good job for the freshman. Good quick start for Calvin Calford. Back we go, an 11-point lead. Oklahoma with the basketball. Rebounded away by Greg Dennis. And here in Nashville, Tennessee, a bit of a surprise brewing early. 8:45 to play. East Tennessee State leading Oklahoma by 11. The Sooners, who struggled in the Big 8 tournament, continue to struggle a bit here in the first round of the NCAA.
They started out, the Sooners trying to go down and establish their inside game. After they went inside a few times, the Buccaneers started to drop people down inside, and it's going to be up to the outside shooting for Oklahoma to rescue this game, probably.
And Mookie Blaylock in foul trouble. He's on the bench. Keller gets it to Dennis. He slams it home. 10 points for Greg Dennis. And a 13-point Buccaneer lead.
Good job by Chad Keller that time, penetrating and then seeing the open man for the easy shot.
King missed everything, and then on the rebound, a foul called. The foul will go against Skeeter Henry of Oklahoma.
Watch Keller going in here, penetrate, gets his man up in the air, and then Dennis just comes in and stuffs it down.
Well, after Andre Wiley had moved away, there was nobody home.
Nope. That's what the penetration will do. It'll draw a defensive man to you and open up another player.
8 minutes remaining first half. 29-16 East Tennessee State.
Buccaneers have done a good job of getting out on the break. They are a running team, but for this game, they tried to hold it down, doing a good job of in the half-court offense.
They would still like it up in the 80s if they can get it there. They don't want it in the hundreds, though. Cowper's hanging jumper won't go. Wiley with a rebound for Oklahoma. Moves it off to Mullins. He stopped, and it's Jennings back the other way to lay it in.
Well, things going wrong for the Sooners right now. The number four team in the country and the number one seed in this regional.
Down by 15 points.
There's Jennings again. Almost gets it.
King tries to answer and does. Stacy King has been the stopper for Oklahoma. He's got 10 points out of the 18 that Oklahoma has at this point. Very low scoring first half for the Sooners.
Well, as we say, they struggled the last three ball games, only shooting about 42%, and that continues to haunt them here. And poor defense like that will get you in trouble. Give the baseline away.
Alvin West with eight. He used the baseline well. They stretch it back to a 15-point lead, 6:50 to play first half.
Oklahoma man for man, and the people away from the ball are keeping the Sooners active and keeping from coming to help on defense at last play.
Stacy a little upset because he was fouled by Keller before he could get the shot to roll in.
Let's watch it right here. Here goes the baseline. You see the move on the other side. Nobody reacting for Oklahoma. Way too late.
Stacy King admitting that Oklahoma did not get up for the Big 8 tournament. Billy Tubbs took it farther than that. He said that postseason tournaments have outlived their usefulness.
Well, that would bother me a little bit if the players and are saying, well, we're not ready for this, but we'll get up for the NCAA. I think it's tough to say that. You're just going to not play this game and get up for the next one. Huh?
Well, it's easy to say it. It's tougher
to
do.
Yeah, tougher to do.
Oklahoma with the basketball, and the Sooners inside. It's an offensive foul on Chad Keller. Away from the ball, trying to set up something inside.
A lot of contact inside. There's Keller going against King. Right there pushing back. King over the top. Keller gets belted pretty good. Now the two guys jawing at each other. Little conversation.
It's tough when you get your head torn off and you got the foul at the same time.
Well, I'm sure a little frustration on the part of King right now. The Sooners down by 15.
Bad pass and a steal. Talford coming back.
Oh, what a move.
Oh, great shot by Talford. He has 10 points.
We talked about this kid, a great athlete, set Virginia High School state records in the triple jump, 48-6, and the long jump at 23-6. So, tremendous talent. Oh, what a move by King.
Stacy King trying to hold the fort for Billy Tubbs right now with 12, but Oklahoma has trailed by as many as 17. They are down 15 right now, and the Sooners are going to have to dig themselves out of a hole.
And the Sooners can strike you in a hurry. They have that kind of ball club. I think it's going to be important for them to fall back in this ball game and get it into single digits at least by halftime.
Sooners come up with the steal. Stacy King blocked. And the follow is good underneath. A good follow that time by Damon Patterson.
Might have gotten a break there, the Sooners. It looked like King might have had the offensive foul. Defensive man looked like he was set.
35-22. East Tennessee has led all the way. The Buccaneers came ready to play. A very young team, maybe the youngest in the 64-team field, with three sophomores and two freshmen in the starting lineup. Dennis along the baseline. Stripped of the basketball, and he's fouled by King.
The foul starting to mount. Here comes King. Let's watch it. This is a possession down before. Defensive man sets. He just runs right over him. I think it should have been an offensive foul. Looked like he had good position. Sooners end up with a bucket. Good break for the Sooners.
Jennings back in the lineup. Alvin West sits down as Billy Tubbs fucks things over with Jody Sylvester. 5:20 to play in the first half. Dennis will go to the line, where he's a good foul shooter. 77.3. When they recruited him, he was 6'6". If he rolls home the foul shot, he is now 6'11". He's growing up, but he hasn't grown out too much yet.
Well, he's got 10 points in the ball game, so he's now become a 1,000-point scorer in only his second year as a sophomore for the Buccaneers.
Two from the line for Greg Dennis. 37-22, a 15-point lead. The Buccaneers have been up by as many as 17. Blaylock with three fouls is back on the court.
He's just not going to be as aggressive with the ball. With the penetration.
The turnover, thanks to the effort by Calvin Talford.
Well, the quickness of the Buccaneers is something else. We said they're going to be as quick a ball club as the Sooners. They go for the ball. Jones, Talford comes in, lets it go, and then Jones just dribbles it out of bounds. This
so
guy's
far,
gotta be happy right
he
now.
He likes what he sees. He took over 4 years ago, a program that also spent 1 year on probation. So he has really had to kind of start from scratch again with East Tennessee State.
I want to point out it wasn't his probation, Les Robinson. He wasn't a part of that. He suffered the penalties, but he's really got his club coming back. And as young as they are, they've got something kind of future to look forward to. And yeah. They've got a present, too, and not just a future.
And presently, they have a 15-point lead over Oklahoma with 4:44 to play in the first half. A timeout on the court. Billy Tubbs wants to talk it over. It's East Tennessee State 37, Oklahoma 22. Any use of this program without written consent is prohibited. The announcers for this program have been approved and contracted by NCAA Productions. Gary, you mentioned it at the start, the shooting woes for Oklahoma, and they're not much better this afternoon.
No, even worse than what they've averaged. We talked about the last three ball games, down 36%. The Buccaneers shooting the ball well.
And there's a turnover. So add one more to the Sooners' total. Let's make it seven.
This is an area that Les Robinson was worried about with the Buccaneers. Here's what we missed on the throw-in right there, the pressure. We talk about the quickness of this Buccaneer club. They are extremely quick. They're going to match up with Oklahoma today in the quickness area.
Sooners are going to have to turn it up a notch, especially on defense now, to get back in the basketball game.
And it may be tough to do it man for man on the press, on full court press, and particularly with Blaylock with three fouls. I think they may have to go to trap, and you may see that in the second half.
Mr. Jennings with it against Mookie Blaylock. Blaylock playing with three fouls. Dennis, jumper against King, is good. So Dennis is lighting it up with 14 points in the first half and back once again to a 17-point Buccaneer lead.
And he's a player. He knows what to do with that basketball once he gets it. He can take it inside or he can go outside.
Mullins was cut off and still gets the jumper.
That should help his confidence. He said he's been struggling, only 41% from the air.
6 points for Terrence Mullins in the game. Michael Woods is in the lineup right now for East Tennessee State. Woods has the basketball.
Les Robinson's done a good job of rotating people and getting some rest.
And a foul called inside on the rebound attempt. I think it might be against Michael Woods.
So we go up with Dennis again up there, get the tip in, and Woods over the top gets called for the foul.
Each team is now in the bonus, so we'll make the long walk to the other end, and we will be in front of the East Tennessee State bench. Blaylock has not scored.
Averaging just a little over 20 points a ball game. When you lose that kind of production, it really hurts you.
Stacey King has been trying to hold him off. Rims out, Dennis with a rebound, and at this point in the ballgame, you have to say East Tennessee State simply playing harder than Oklahoma.
Well, they certainly are, and that's been a problem again for the Sooners over the last few ballgames, just to play motivated. Like I said, they talk themselves, they're going to get ready for this NCAA. There's a steal.
And Blaylock will take it in against Jennings and roll it home.
Boy, he did a nice job there. He showed Jennings the ball up high, let Jennings go behind, and then took it underneath and laid it up. This is what the Buccaneers are doing. Well, they come out on a break situation. If it's not there, they're taking it back out, setting up, running a good half-court offense, getting some good shots.
And because of the mobility of this youngster, Dennis, they've been able to enter the ball like this, right off the baseline, give him a chance. Doesn't get the roll, but he had the shot.
Can't ask for any more than that.
Mullins outside, starts to move, jumps it up, and hits. So Mullins starting to warm it up. He's got 8 points.
That's the Sooners game right there. They have to shoot.
They have sliced a 17-point lead to 10. 2:30 to play first half in Nashville, Tennessee. I'm John Sanders along with Gary Thompson. Delighted to have you with us this afternoon. A surprising start to this one. We'll see how the finish is.
I think the Sooners have picked up the defensive intensity here in the last, three, 4 minutes. They're hanging back a little bit, playing a little soft. It seems to be going after them a little stronger.
Jennings 13 on the shot clock. King gets the turnover. It's a 3-on-2. King drops it off and almost gave it away. Blaylock along the baseline. His jumper hits the edge of the backboard. Might have been blocked partially. Less than 2 minutes to play first half. A 10-point East Tennessee State lead.
He said, I think Tubbs will feel real good if he could get out of this first half in single digits. They're down to 10, but possession of the basketball to the Buccaneers. And they have good movement on their offense. They're really keeping everybody moving. Nobody standing still. And that makes it tough to cover, particularly when you have to play defense for 25 seconds like this.
Now only 6 seconds on the shot clock. Jennings spinning inside. Can't hit the shot. And over the back, picking up the foul is Dennis. That's his second. So Dennis with two, King with two. The only player in foul trouble is Mookie Blaylock with three.
We'll watch to see if they get Dennis out of the lineup now for the last minute. You see, Blaylock with three fouls has to turn him loose. Jennings goes up. King up high for the rebound, and Dennis over the top builds up or picks up his two, and Billy Tubbs likes that.
Yes, well, we are going to have the substitution into the lineup. I think Keller's probably going to replace Dennis.
This is a good move. He can protect Dennis with only 110 to play.
110 to play, and Oklahoma has scored 29 points in the first half. Do you believe that? It's true. Gear back in the ball game, but it is Keller who takes the spot of Dennis. King at the line for the first time. Misses the front end of a 1-and-1, and it's rebounded by Gear.
And Oklahoma only has 68% free throw shooting club, and yet a game like this, you're going to have to shoot those free throws.
Minute to play, first half, 10-point lead, East Tennessee State. Oklahoma has never led in the game. Jennings, who runs the offense.
Three fouls on Blaylock, and let Jennings kind of pick his way because Mookie Blaylock just cannot go after and put the kind of pressure on him that he likely. You see him dropping back right there.
Keller.
Excuse me, John. I was going to say, Blaylock, if he makes the steal, then he's probably going to come off passes from other players and not covering Jennings.
Alvin West misses. He hit his first two, and I think he's missed 4 3-pointers in a row. It'll be Oklahoma basketball with 24 seconds left.
Well, West hit nothing but net those first two, and the last few, he's got nothing but air.
That's right. There's the difference, 10 points with 20 seconds to play. The Sooners will, as you mentioned, try to cut it inside that 10.
Well, they'll hold for one here, and this could be a big momentum basket for Oklahoma if they could get one down here and go in by 8.
You're going to have to hurry, knocked away and out of bounds with 5 seconds to play first half.
Again, the quickness of the Buccaneers. That was a good back cut set up right there, but the quickness able to get a hand on it. I think that was West. It reached in and deflected, knocked it away.
Woods will check back into the lineup along with Rodney Jones. Now, these are defensive changes made by Coach Robinson. Rodney Jones is primarily a defensive player, rarely shoots the basketball.
This will definitely be the lowest scoring half for the Sooners this year. We've got 6 players on the floor.
Now they're going to discuss it between the officials.
They're trying to slide Keller out of there right now.
They waved it off. It is a bit confusing. Now, that's one of the factors with the bench there, players standing. Sometimes you cannot be sure who's in and who's out.
And Keller was definitely standing right underneath the basket.
To King. As the first half ends, it rolls
big basket.
Home. 14 points for Stacey King. The Sooners have moved inside the 10-point difference mark. Halftime, Les Robinson's team is ahead. That's the end of the first half. Our score here is East Tennessee State 39, Oklahoma 31. We'll be back after this message and a word from your local station. This is an NCAA Productions telecast. Iowa State 46-37 at halftime in the semifinal. And in the final game, Missouri led them 44-36 at the halftime. So that has been an alarming trend, and it has continued. Check out the stats in the first half.
You see the shooting. Oklahoma finally brought it back to 43%. The Buccaneers were shooting around 48-50% at one time, dropped back. The Sooners still struggling, only 22% in a Big Eight tournament from the three-point line. That's been a big part of their offense.
Dennis leading the way with 14 for East Tennessee State. Talford, who got him off quickly out of the blocks, And the only person putting it in the hoop for Oklahoma in the first half is Stacey King. So here we go with the second half of play. Tony Martin will start the second half for Oklahoma. So one change. Here is an upset in the East. Siena with a two-point win over the Cardinal of Stanford. Blaylock along the baseline reverses. King with a rebound stripped from him, and a foul inside is called. The foul is going to go on Marty Story, and I've got three on him. So Story with three, and it'll put King immediately at the line. Oklahoma is down by eight.
Well, it's important psychologically right here for King to get down some free throws with Oklahoma in possession of the basketball, come out, cut the lead a little further, and put some more pressure on the Buccaneers, because we've talked about how youthful this club is.
King has missed all three of his foul shots this afternoon. At the other end, Talford against Mullins, and he's hammered. Terrence Mullins' first foul, and Talford, who has great quickness, good athletic ability, will go to the line.
Oh, he has great leaping ability, too. Blaylock can't come up with it. Mr. Jennings right ahead. Talford down there on the break. Mullins goes up with him. Doesn't let Talford get in to his explosive jumping ability. He's high jumped 6'11", this kid. Just, we talk about all the athletic talent he has.
This summer, he'll be playing professional baseball in the Philadelphia Phillies organization. A freshman. Keep in mind, three sophomores, two freshmen in the starting lineup.
This is a big turnaround right here. Oklahoma misses out on 2 points, and the Buccaneers get two on the other end. Instead of going to six, it stretches to 10.
41-31. The Sooners have been down by as many as 17. Mookie Blaylock from the side. His jump shot short. Martin loses it out of bounds, and it'll be East Tennessee State basketball. So the Buccaneers will get it back. Checking some other scores. Arkansas is leading Loyola Marymount 109-96. The upset, Siena over Stanford. Of course, Siena beat the University of Pittsburgh early in the year.
I tell you, when you get into these tournaments, anything can happen. The adrenaline and emotions get to rolling with the team, and particularly the underdogs seem to really come up strong.
First foul by Tony Martin. Let's take another look at it, and it'll be Alvin West to the line. He got the penetration.
You see the quickness there by West. Beats Mullins. And
as a team, the Buccaneers are 4 out of 5 at the foul line. They shoot it pretty well from the line.
74% as a team.
Alvin West with 9 points this afternoon. 1 out of 2 is all, but the Buccaneers are going to get it back. And we have 19 minutes remaining in the game. An 11-point lead for East Tennessee State. Talford has it taken away. Now King. He'll have to slow it down. No place for Stacey to go. Blaylock to Mullins.
Good drive by Jones that time, controlling the ball and keeping the possession.
King works the baseline, missed the shot, follows, and scores.
King 7 for 12 in the first half.
So Stacey immediately hits 1 out of 2 in that exchange and has 16. Jennings all the way, gives it up, and laying it home is Marty Story, his first basket.
Well, there was a similar play to what King had in the first half. He didn't call the offensive foul. Now as a team, both teams have to adjust and know that the officials are consistent, and that's the way it's probably going to be called.
Long lead pass to Jennings. His baseline jump shot, good. Jennings with 6 points. The lead grows to 13.
This is really going to make it tough for the Sooners. Billy Cubb getting a timeout.
So we do have a timeout on the court. 17:59 to play. East Tennessee State 46, Oklahoma 33. 46-33 is our score. Oklahoma has the ball, down by 13. Now Jody Sylvester says, hang on a minute. 2 for 2 in the second half for East Tennessee State. Oklahoma 1 out of 5. Blaylock, covered by Talford, gets it back to Mullins. They swing it to Davis. Now Davis to Jones. They enter the ball. King works the baseline, but he's cut off by Dennis. The shot blocked. Stripped from behind by Jennings. He's got Talford with him, 2-on-1. Knocked away, and Mullins draws the foul. He's second.
Jennings really doing a good job. Playmaker on his club. Was only 2-for-4 offensively in the first half, but 5 assists. Really running the job. Stacey King forces the shot. He's got to bide his time. Look at Jennings. Leads the conference in steals with 66. Good bounce pass. Telfer takes it up. Mullins there to foul. Sends him to the line to make the two.
And Telfer is 2-for-2, and there is Mr. Jennings. There's a young man. His dad was his coach. He would not answer to Keith. His dad started calling him Mister. He got his attention, and the name stayed with him. East Tennessee State by 15. Talford has 14 in the game, and off the bench for Oklahoma comes Skeeter Henry.
In this club, we talked about all the youth, but they matured and had a heck of a Southern Conference tournament. All but Story made the all-conference tournament team. Quite a feat, four guys up on one club.
Jones sits down for Oklahoma. He's averaging 13 a game, has not scored. Blaylock from outside does not get the roll. Davis to follow. It won't go. Picked up once. Now King lays it in. Stacey King has 18 points. It's been Stacey King against East Tennessee State.
Well, it certainly has. And Blaylock, boy, it's unbelievable how his shooting has gone sour. He's only 10 out of the last 35 coming into this game.
Mullins missed the layup. Here's King, hammered away that time, and the foul called on Calvin Talford, his first. 17:04 to play. Billy Tubbs' team has trailed the entire game.
Kind of sums things up for the Sooners there. Mullins come down, missed the layup. A good pass by Henry, finding King, who has the hot hands over the top with the foul, is Talford.
Now, if you're Les Robinson, you can't really change anything, but you got every now and then look up at the scoreboard, see where you stand according to the clock and the score.
Well, that's important, but not in this stage of the game with 17 minutes. They got too much time to start thinking anything about clock. They have to just continue to play the same style of basketball they've been playing.
King looking for his 20th point. He's got it. So Stacey, 2 out of 5 at the line, 20 in the game. The lead is 11. 17 to play.
Those two free throws he missed started this second half, I think, was a big, big play, because it could have gone to 6-point lead and changed momentum in the game.
A 3-on-1. Henry traveled with the ball, and he got the pressure from Calvin Talford.
Well, the Oklahoma bench up. They want a foul as Talford cut in behind, but the officials were trailing the play, couldn't see. On the steal, there he comes behind. I don't know if he gets him, unless he gets him on the leg as he brushes by and throws Henry off balance. It causes the walk. Henry's upset with it.
Jennings will work with West to bring it up. Chad Keller has checked into the lineup for East Tennessee State. He and Davis are both out there along with Talford. That's the lineup right now. Mookie Blaylock playing with 3 fouls. Jennings gets him in the air, can't get the roll. Knocked out of bounds, touched last by Jennings. It'll be OU basketball.
Lucky break for the Sooners right there, because he had Blaylock up where he wanted it and almost drew his 4th foul. See the ball?
Oh, right off his foot.
Good call. This one did not.
Stacey King outside. Now Blaylock from the side. This is for 2, and he's got it. Mookie Blaylock now only 5 points in the game. He had 3 in the first half. That's his first field goal in the second half.
They really need his shooting.
Now it's a 9-point lead, 16 minutes to play. That's a 3 that misses. Davis is there for the rebound. Or Dennis is there for the rebound. And it'll be OU ball.
The Sooners more aggressive on defense, and Les Robinson looked like, thought he was motioning for timeout. Once it's the next time.
They got him on the way in. The basket will not count. The foul will go on Jennings. It'll be his 2nd. 48-39. It was 39-31. Les Robinson and the Buccaneers at halftime. Led by 17 at one point in the first half. And Major Gear checks in. Checking out is Alvin West. Alvin hit his first 2 3-pointers, Gary, and since then, nothing.
That's right. He struggled. Gear coming in, remembers a good 3-point shooter. Had 6 in 1 game this year. That was against Marshall.
Jennings, foul number 3.
Now it's even Steven. Jennings and Blaylock each with three fouls. Jennings is not going to be able to be as aggressive defensively. He comes up, overcommits right there as he charges up on Blaylock, and it gets the foul from behind.
So Blaylock will go to the line. Mookie's one out of two. 5 points in the game. The Sooners are down by nine. Blaylock, the junior college transfer. He's from Garland, Texas. Bends in the second one. Two for two for Mookie. Seven in the game. The lead is seven. A 9-0 Oklahoma run. So the Sooners are starting back. 48-41. Nice jump shot on a good feed. Keller gets the basket, but Jennings gets the credit.
And Keller's got a good soft touch inside. He can score. He's averaging a little over 8 points a ball game. Good rebounder, too.
Keller trying to front Stacey King right now. Henry traveled with it. And again, good pressure defensively by Calvin Telford.
They are quick. This quickness of this club will match up against Oklahoma at almost every position. Watch the pressure as he beats it right here, gets in front, cuts him off, and then causes the walk.
15 minutes to go in the game. Jennings. Running that offense. Cut off nicely that time by Davis. Jennings even starting to create more than he did in the first half. Draws the foul by Henry. On Skeeter, his second.
It'll look like Stacey King was talking to Henry right here, saying, hey, let him go. Now he's in trouble. He's going up right here. Henry comes over, gets in the way, reaches in and grabs. This mister was in a tough situation that time to get a decent shot off.
Mister was where he didn't want to be. They will inbounds under their own basket and in front of their own bench in an arena that's full of corners. So many corners, there are nine scoreboards. It's almost like four different crowds on each side and each end of the building. Not even like you're at the same event because you can't see anybody else.
And then again, pressuring on defense, picking up a little bit more aggressive, trying to overplay the passing lanes.
Again, the penetration, the shot by Telford won't go. Keller with a rebound. A new 45 on the shot clock for East Tennessee State. They wanted a foul call there, the fans did, and obviously there are a lot of East Tennessee State fans here. They've loved it so far, haven't they?
They really have, and they've had a lot to cheer about, too.
Jennings for three, no. Kept alive that time by Dennis. Now down the lane, here's Keller, he's fouled from behind.
Well, Buccaneers now playing their two big guys. Dennis, good penetration here, causes trouble, dishes it off. Keller goes up and then fouled from behind as he gets inside defensively, looks like on Skeeter Henry.
And that is three on Skeeter Henry. It's the 15th foul on Oklahoma. And into the game comes Michael Woods from Kings Mountain, North Carolina. Jennings will get a hand as he sits down. Well deserved.
You said before, you do not have to worry too much about Woods scoring. He's basically a defensive stopper. His high this year is 5 points, and that was in the first game of the year.
Keller hits the foul shot. The Buccaneers have missed only once from the foul line. That could be very important as we go down the stretch.
You can count on that. If they continue to lead and get down in that point, we have to area of time we have to start fouling. There's 74% as a team.
Blaylock, jump shot from outside is short. Keller kept it alive and then knocks it out of bounds. Dennis was going to have the rebound, but you can't fault Keller for his aggressiveness.
I think Blaylock has to just take the shot in the offense. Take it when it comes. He's trying to create something there. Really, really hesitant on his offense.
King with it. No place to go. Now Mullins. Sooners say they've had a good week of practice. Going to get back to Oklahoma basketball the way it used to be.
They shot the ball real well here yesterday in practice. The three-point range said they had a great scrimmage at Oklahoma before they left.
22 points for Stacey King. Knocked out of bounds. Touched last by the Sooners. A 9-point East Tennessee State lead with 13:15 remaining in the game. Dennis is fouled. And Skeeter Henry's getting himself in big trouble in a hurry. That's four. All here in the second half.
Dennis doing a good job showing with the offhand where he wants the basketball. They put it there, and Henry comes in. Makes the foul, sent Dennis to the line. He's a 77% free throw shooter.
Jennings checks back into the lineup, and Damon Patterson, number 31 for Oklahoma. So Patterson, the sophomore from Kalamazoo, a Proposition 48 player, is in the lineup.
Started a few games early in the season, but hasn't seen much action here in the last part of the year.
Dennis, very smooth. That's his first point in the second half.
We said he's a sophomore, but he's started 59 consecutive games, so he's got a lot of playing time. Really gained some experience.
16 for him. Back to an 11-point lead. You see the time remaining, 13:06.
You notice on defense, they have Keller protecting Dennis. He's got a lot of bulk and strength, but he's going to have a tough time covering Stacey King.
24 now for the All-American from Oklahoma, the candidate for the Wooden Award.
Oklahoma going into the zone. Looks like they're in a 2-1-2.
12:40 to play.
At this stage, they can afford to go zone with that much time. You see a few possessions. Key right now will be for the Buccaneers if they use some clock out of the zone and then end up hitting the shot. It really puts the pressure on the Sooners.
But also get their offense in gear in time to get a good shot. Inside 10 seconds now on the shot clock. Six. It's going to be Jennings to work the baseline. Little lane running jumper followed by Dennis. No good, and a foul from behind by Talford. Talford picks up his second.
That'll be the team's fifth. Here they come, clock working down. It gets a tough shot coming out of here, and then gets the tip. Nobody checking off Dennis, and then Davis going for the ball. Over the top is Telford.
Five team fouls now on East Tennessee State. Six against Oklahoma. King along the baseline, turns around, uses the glass. Davis is there for the follow.
Davis, we mentioned earlier in the first half, a good offensive rebounder. 23 rebounds in the Big 8 tournament.
That's his first field goal. The lead is down to seven. Plenty of time, 11:50 to go in the game. We're at Memorial Gym in Nashville, Tennessee.
Well, with this zone right now, and they're going to get a timeout, I see, it's hurting, I think, the rhythm of this Buccaneer ball club.
A timeout down on the court. 11:40 to play in the ball game. A score right now, East Tennessee State 54, Oklahoma 47.
Buccaneers right now missing some shots. Easy shots that put the pressure on them. Oklahoma a chance now to really bounce in. They go down low to Davis.
Davis uses the glass and bangs it home. His second consecutive field goal. He has 6 points in the game. The lead is five. At one time, there was a 17-point difference, but the Sooners have come scratching back. They really haven't done it with a big burst either. They're not one of their real strong runs. They've kind of inched their way back into ballgame. Keller has been out on the court a lot, helping take the pressure off Dennis, who has it along the baseline.
Again, I got a comment about this change in defense by Billy Tubbs. It's caused this team, the Buccaneers, to stand around on the man-for-man defense. They're really moving good, using their quickness. Now they're doing a lot of standing. They're running that clock down. They're in trouble again.
From way outside, three-pointer, a beauty by Gear, his second of the game. And there are only about 2 seconds left on the shot clock.
What a big play for the Buccaneers. What a killer if you're an Oklahoma Sooner fan.
Blaylock answers at the other end. Mookie with nine, six here in the second half. 10:12 to play. A six-point lead for East Tennessee State.
Some of the fans now starting to chant boring.
Those are Oklahoma fans. Almost thrown away. Jennings saves to Gear. Mullins with some pressure. Almost thrown away again. Again, less than 10 on the shot clock. Calford will take it into the lane, give it back to Dennis. He rolls it in.
Good job by Calford, their penetration, and a good job by Dennis of stepping in to receive the pass.
And he used every second of the shot clock again. King blocked by Dennis and a foul. On Greg Dennis, number three. Let's look at it.
Well, they keep going inside. King, here comes Dennis from the offside, goes up. And boy, he gets a lot of ball, but he does get the body on the follow through, and I think that's where the foul is called. Here we go. Penetration by Calford. Look at Dennis step in. This one's the other end moments ago. Shortens up the shot, lays it in, gets a big two.
59-51, East Tennessee State. Checking in once again, Marty Story, one of the starters, and Calford will get a rest. Also back into the lineup is Alvin West, who had those early three-pointers. He'll pick it up for Major Gear.
And one advantage for the Buccaneers is he rotates, Les Robinson rotates his kids, as they played eight people most of the year, so he's able to rotate in and keep kids rested going against his Oklahoma team that can run all afternoon.
And Jody Sylvester making sure everyone at the scorer's table knows exactly what's going on. King at the line.
Talked about free throws, going to be crucial for Oklahoma as they try and come from behind. Here's King on the line again.
Stacy's made his last three attempts. 25 points, Les Robinson. 9:19 to go must seem like an eternity to him.
King knows his average at 26.
So the senior from Lawton leading the way for the Sooners at 59-53. King has almost half of the Oklahoma points.
See what the Buccaneers can do against his zone. As I say, basically standing. Got Dennis down inside.
Almost knocked away from Keller. Jennings gives it to Dennis. He lost it going up, but he draws the foul anyway.
See, Patterson committed the sin again. We'll talk about on Jennings. He's going to show you the up fake. Patterson leaves his feet. Watch here. Up fake. Up he goes. Over commits. Penetration forces the defense come off. And Dennis again with the good step in and draws the foul.
So Greg will go to the line where the sophomore is 4 out of 4 this afternoon. It's 59-53. East Tennessee State leading Oklahoma. 19 for Greg Dennis, above his average of 17.
He said in the top, he leads his club both scoring and rebound.
And he has 20 points in the ballgame.
A year ago, he was freshman of the year, first team all-conference performer this year. That's Greg Dennis. Trying to work on him right now with Davis.
Davis doing a pretty good job in the last three or four possessions. He's got three baskets. 61-55. The lead for the Buccaneers is 6. They're in blue. The Sooners, the higher seeded team, the home team in white from Norman, Oklahoma. Story along the baseline. Not really pressured. Tries to skip it across. On. He threw it away. Here's Blaylock. Draws the foul. Alvin West with his first, and Mookie will go to the line.
Well, Mister has tried that same play several times, and it's worked, and this time he doesn't get it done. Here comes Blaylock, looks his man off, takes the ball away, makes it a tough shot, but draws the foul.
So each team now over the limit as far as fouls are concerned. We will shoot them all in the last 8 minutes and 14 seconds. Blaylock is 3 out of 4 at the line in this game, make it 4 out of 5. 10 points for the senior.
As you look at Mookie right there, the only player in the NCAA to post back-to-back 200 assists and 100 steals in 1 year. Quite a feat for this kid. Really quick.
Mookie has 11 in the ball game. We have 8:10 to play. The lead is down to 4. At one point, East Tennessee State was up by 17. They led by 8 at halftime. Oklahoma has cut that in half.
And the Buccaneers have to find some way to solve the zone and get a good shot. Sometimes they penetrated there again, leaving their feet.
Jennings gives up the dribble, skips it across to Alvin West. Marty Story now, pressured by Blaylock. He almost came up with the steal. West along the baseline, off the glass and good. Great move by Alvin West. He's got 11.
Key shot. He's a kid. Had a big game against Wake Forest.
Oh, what a block. Dennis blocked and Oklahoma gets it back.
He leads this club in block shots. Has 38, just added 39 at least.
And Patterson misses everything on the three-point attempt. Jennings will pull it back out. East Tennessee State leading by 6, 7:03 to play in the game.
And the Sooners are going to have right now in that zone. They're going to have patience, play good defense, and stay with it all the way. Big block there.
And King with a follow. Long lead to Mookie Blaylock. Almost stepped out of bounds. Patterson is fouled. Foul goes on Marty Story. He's got 4.
Well, you see some athletic ability here. Well, Blaylock saved the ball with a good catch. Here's Patterson with the ball thrown behind him. Makes a good catch, and then gets fouled.
So 4 on him, and to the line for the first time is Patterson. Only shooting about 54% at the line, and you see why.
And the foul trouble may play an important part. Dennis has 3. Jennings has 3. Story now has 4.
Missed them both. And a foul called on Davis of Oklahoma. William Davis, the junior from Wyandotte High School in Kansas City, Kansas, for Billy Tubbs, draws the foul.
And Patterson struggling at the line. Coming out there, and Davis just moves right back into him.
So Marty Story will go to the line. Started his freshman year at Clemson on the football team. A little homesick, decided to come back to the state of Tennessee. Sat out all of last year, did not play for Clemson, so he is still a freshman. In effect, he has redshirted his freshman year.
Story on the line. Very instrumental in their championship game against Marshall. Had 8 points and 8 rebounds. Played very well.
Tyrone Jones, number 22, is checked back in for Oklahoma.
See the Oklahoma kids trying to get together right there, trying to pump each other up, trying to pull this one out. They'll have to keep the Buccaneers off the foul line. We've talked about it several times now. They're a good free throw shooting club.
2 for Marty Story, 4 points in the game. They're loving it in Johnson City, Tennessee, where with 6:45 to play, the Buccaneers are up by 8. Blaylock looks to King, decides not to go that way. Jones outside, they swing it to Mullen. He looks inside to Davis or to King, now starts his own move. Foul line jumper, bending off, tipped up and in. It is Mookie Blaylock coming in from that weak side.
He can hurt you in a lot of ways. He's been struggling shooting, but defense. Third those boards, good rebound.
13 points for Mookie Blaylock. All alone is Keller, count the basket. Again, Oklahoma overplaying the defense, and Keller gets the easy basket.
Good recognition here. West comes in, penetration. They come in, trailing the play. It's King right there. Keller gets it up. Down would be a chance for a big three-point play the conventional way. Good pass, good feed. King coming from behind. You get another look at it.
3 fouls on Stacey King. To the line is Chad Keller. He's 2 out of 2. Makes a 3 out of 3. He does pick up the three-point play. 7 for him in the game. The lead is back to 9. 6:10 to play here in Nashville, Tennessee. Along with Gary Thompson, I'm John Sanders. Jones will try to answer with a three-pointer. He's got it.
This kid could do it for the Sooners. A great three-point shooter.
He has won 5 games with final shots. 4 of them three-point game-winning baskets. Story trying to get away from Jones.
Oklahoma trying to come strong with the defense. They change up now.
Jennings uses the baseline and then kicks it all the way out to West. He's cut off by Mullins. Back to Jennings. 18 seconds on the shot clock. 5:30 to play in the game. Jennings against Blaylock. Dennis, a long jumper, too long. Davis for Oklahoma. Looks to Jones. It's a 3-on-2. Davis will take it in and draw the foul. He's hooked by Jennings on his way in.
That's a key foul for the Buccaneers. I think that's the 4th on Jennings. Ooh, might have got away with a walk right there. Jones definitely looked like he walked. And then Davis, strong move. And you see Jennings just reach right there. Didn't have a chance to stop anything. He did stop the bucket.
Davis had made a decision. He was going to take it to the hole. Nobody for the Buccaneers could get in his way. Davis, 3 out of 3 at the line, 9 points.
You always look at Davis, a guy with a size, he's got a good body build. Say, well, he's probably not going to be a good free throw shooter, but he's an excellent free throw shooter.
Made all 4 of his attempts this afternoon. He's in double figures at 10 points. 68-64. East Tennessee State by 4, 5:10 to go.
And the zone got Oklahoma back in, stopped the momentum of the Buccaneers, and they made a run, and Tubbs been back man for man now for a few possessions.
Mullins with his 4th foul. So Mullins has 4, Skeeter Henry has 4, Jennings and Story have 4 for East Tennessee State.
Well, Mullins trying to play defense with his feet that time, keeping his hands out, just couldn't get there quick enough. And again, Oklahoma's going to have to keep him off the line.
So a word with Coach Tubbs. Mullins will stay on the court. At the foul line, Alvin West hits it. The sophomore from Havelock, North Carolina. 12 points in the game for him. He got him out to that quick start with a couple of three-pointers.
Marty Story is about the only kid who doesn't shoot free throws well. He's shooting at 55%. Everybody else is in the 70% range.
Davis off the glass and in. William Davis is helping to pick the Sooners up. He's got a dozen now, and the lead is down to 3 points. The Buccaneers have led the Sooners all the way.
Now it's going to come down to the point. We've got a foul on Jones inside. I was going to say, with the Buccaneers, Oklahoma's been in this tough situation many, many times. And the Buccaneers, you come to the point where you want this win so bad, now you got to seal it up, and that's a tough thing to do for a young club.
You have to continue to play the same style that got you the lead to begin with. Marty Story is 2 out of 2 at the line. They'll all be big from here on in.
Only said if you're going to foul a guy, this is the guy to foul. And good hustle by Jennings. Ooh.
Almost could have called a foul on Stacey King. 4:36 to play in the game. A timeout on the court. East Tennessee State 69, Oklahoma 66.
Coach for East Tennessee State was upset on this last call. Let's see why. And I think he has a reason to be, as Jennings beats King to the spot. A good break for the Sooners in more than one way. They get possession of the basketball. That would have been the 4th foul on King, and really taken his some of his aggressiveness away, both defensively and offensively. And he's still questioning the call.
He's questioning the call with referee and one of the officials, Ron Labadich. 4:36 to go in the game. Oklahoma down by 3. They could tie on this possession.
I was going to say, they finally have it to the point where they're one possession away. That's way out there.
3-on-1 for the Buccaneers. A little slow delivering the ball, and King comes up with it. A little hesitation by Alvin West.
I don't think a good choice in the last possession by Oklahoma by Mookie Blaylock. He has not been stroking the shot well, and he's way out behind that three-point line. They got to get a better shot.
Must have called the 900 number and voted for the pro range.
Now we've got zone on the other end to see if Oklahoma, they go right inside.
So didn't want to do that. The foul's going to go against Dennis. No basket, but Greg Dennis picks up number 4, and he knew he was out of position.
He's right, and a real concerned guy you just saw there, Coach Les Robinson, because Dennis now has 4 fouls, maybe a little youth here. He's definitely blocked out inside. He tries to go over the top. Davis will not get the basket. He'll go to the line. But Davis, a real force, a key kid for Oklahoma down the stretch.
Absolutely. 10 points for him in the second half. At the line, he has made 4 out of 4. That is his first miss. But King throws it up, misses. The Buccaneers have it. They still lead by 3. Long lead pass to Alvin West. Now Jennings against Blaylock.
And this 1-on-1 can really be expensive. They really put the pressure on East Tennessee State. They could have come down this possession only trailing by 1, knowing they have to score or they could give up the lead.
3:28 to go. Tip up and almost in, but a foul call. Foul's going to go against East Tennessee State, who walked back the other way.
That was good defense by King. He comes in here to help, makes him change the shot right here. West comes away, and then King up for the rebound.
And it was West who committed the foul.
Over the top. How many times do you see that? You come away, do not make the play, and then continue on and make a make a foul.
Maybe Alvin West trying to do too much right now. King with a basket. Five straight at the line for Stacey King. 27 in the game now. Talford is checked back in for Marty Story for East Tennessee State. King cuts the lead to one. 28 points for Stacey King. 69-68. 3:17 to go. Hang on.
Oh, King almost had a steal.
Jennings takes it up and a crowd gives it back. West missed. Tip try no good, and Davis a rebound for Oklahoma.
What a key player for the Sooners. Again, down the stretch, big rebound. Sooners still get up in the air on Mister right there. Every time he shows them the up fake, they're taking it, and it's causing them some problems. They get out of it that time.
Steal by West, and he's fouled. Oh, he tipped out of bounds. Almost had the turnover.
That's West right here as he comes out. Watch it slow. Right there, he gets a piece of the line. Just that second step.
Very tiny piece of the line. Mullins jumper. Gonna be short. Here comes West. One on three. You ought to bring it back out.
Yeah. In that situation, I'd have been looking for my guys down inside. I'd have been going to King and Davis right now.
It'll be the Buccaneers calling a timeout. They've got the lead with 2:20 to play. East Tennessee State, 69. The fourth-ranked Sooners of Oklahoma, 68 to play. The Buccaneers have called time. Anything special you think they might try to do? They have 36 seconds left on the shot clock. You can see the foul situation for Dennis Jennings and Story. But what about the Buccaneers on this possession?
Well, I think Jennings, Oklahoma's been man for man. He's going to be a key guy here, maybe on a penetration. Into the middle, they've been able to do that and kick off maybe to Dennis or Telford in there. Let's see what happens.
It's Alvin West with it. Dennis pops out and they throw it away.
We'll never know right there on that possession, boy. Boy, an upset Les Robinson. That's tough, an unforced turnover right there.
To get the ball to Dennis, turns it over to Oklahoma.
And you talked about Jones hitting key shots for Oklahoma, winning five games. Maybe he might be in the picture, but that's where I'd go, is into those two guys.
Davis, oh, what a challenge. He's got 14 points, 12 in the second half, and Oklahoma leads for the first time, 70-69. Halford, West, and Jennings, a minute 40 to play.
Buccaneers, we talked about blocking off so well early in the first half, and now let one go by. Good penetration. That's what we're talking about. Jennings trying to penetrate. He's an excellent foul shooter. So you have two things going for you when he penetrates. Pick the foul up or the dish off.
And that's four on Mookie Blaylock. He, Mullins, and Henry all have four.
It's a little edge. Moves in right there. Draws the foul. Two extremely quick hits going up against each other.
Oklahoma had a tough start last year against the Southern Conference team from Tennessee Chattanooga. It was not an easy win for them in the opening round.
I mentioned Jennings. He's their best at the line, 84.5%. Hits two.
Has eight. Back on top for the Buccaneers by one, 71-70. A minute and 25 seconds left. Blaylock gets the baseline and the basket and the foul.
Well, the senior's been silent for most of this game, but he comes through with a big play right when the Sooners need it the most.
And that will be all for Mr. Jennings.
Little hesitation, change of pace dribbler, gets it by. Jennings makes a mistake right there. He just reaches and grabs. At this point in the game, he knows that he has to stay in the ball game. Is that important to his club? Tubbs liking the play. Assistant coach Jim Kerwin there, and the glasses coming up.
Here's the situation. A minute and 21 seconds left. Oklahoma, just moments ago, got the lead for the first time in the game. The Sooners on the basket by Blaylock, lead by one, 72-71. Blaylock will go to the line. Keith, Mr. Jennings, the playmaker, the leader for East Tennessee State, has fouled out of the ball game. So coming on to replace him will be Major Gear. The Sooners trailed the entire ball game. They were down by 17 in the first half. Oklahoma trailed by 8 at halftime. They have gradually worked themselves back into it thanks to the play of Stacey King, who has 28, and a strong second half for William Davis. Blaylock also strong in the second half with 12 of his 15 points. Bending off. Davis touched it last. So with a minute 20 to go, Billy Tubbs and the Sooners will see the Buccaneers with the basketball.
Let's see if the Buccaneers use the clock. They could get two possessions here to one to Oklahoma.
Only a one-point difference. This is Talford. He'll penetrate, give it back to Keller.
Some good athletes with a lot of quickness. A lot of guys can put the ball on the floor. Talford's one that can get you in the foul situation.
Here's Dennis using the glass up high, trying to follow the shot. They go to the court.
Davis.
Held ball.
Big hit. Ooh. Possession to Buccaneers.
Davis battling hard, but let's also give some credit to Greg Dennis. He went after that missed shot.
Well, there's no time to be timid now, even if you got some foul problems. Right now, 56 seconds. I'm going to say Oklahoma, regardless of what happens, is going to get a possession.
Two timeouts remaining for East Tennessee State. Billy Tubbs and the Sooners have all three of their timeouts remaining. 56 seconds to play, and there's one of the timeouts taken there by Major Gear. 56 seconds to go. It's Oklahoma 72, East Tennessee State 71. Oklahoma leading 72-71 with 56 seconds remaining. East Tennessee State has been hanging on at the foul line because they haven't been able to make any field goals.
Well, I think the zone started the thing. It took them out of the rhythm of their offense. Then when they made a little run, Oklahoma went back man for man. But since then, they really haven't had the good movement in their offense.
And with a new 45 on the shot clock, see how much of the time they take before they decide to take the shot.
Well, in this case, I don't think with 10 or 11 seconds, you've got to make sure right now the score and the time in the game that you get a good shot. You couldn't worry now about getting the shot off in 10 seconds. It has to be a good one. I look for some penetration here. Look to try to pick up the foul.
Keller comes out to help Talford. Now he hands it back to Alvin West. Remember, Jennings is on the bench. He's fouled out. That is a key.
Right.
20 seconds to play in the game. Here's jumper is short.
What a foul.
Dennis. It'll be Oklahoma ball with 11 seconds to play. The Sooners up by one.
Oklahoma has to make sure they put the hands in the ball with somebody who can shoot the free throw. Blaylock, 65% free throw shooter. They got to foul it.
They did. It comes with 8 seconds to play. Blaylock will go to the line, and even if he makes two, it'll give one final chance to East Tennessee State. That foul was charged to Major Gear. His first, and Blaylock to the line. For in the ball game this afternoon, he has made 5 out of 7. Missed his last one, however. 8 seconds remaining. Oklahoma trying to advance against Louisiana Tech.
Let's see if Oklahoma, if he makes the free throws, let's see if they get a timeout call after the make. Big miss.
Tipped up, no
Davis.
Good. Rebound by East Tennessee State. They take timeout. The timeout called before the interception. 2 seconds to play, and East Tennessee State is going to get one more shot at them. Oklahoma by one. It's OU 72, East Tennessee State 71.
Well, Blaylock misses it. Probably one of the best misses that Oklahoma ever had will be right there on the tip-in by Davis because it took a lot of time off the clock. You see right here, the clock's still running, the timeout call there. It looked like it was on four, or you get the...
The timeout call definitely came at four, maybe three. Oklahoma takes timeout. The Sooners have two remaining. East Tennessee State has none remaining. As you look at it, you could either say four or possibly three. As it is, they have two. Now, what's the key on the inbound play?
Well, to me, the key on his inbound play is to put a big man on the ball so that he cannot just have free access or reign to throw the pass and make a good pass. I think you have, that's the start of it. I think you have to have good pressure on that guy. Put my biggest guy right there and jumper. And the guy's taking the ball out of bounds. And then you have to think, don't foul. Try and lead up your people and make them come get the basketball. Come out as high as you can, but you cannot give the back cutter away.
They put the clock back to four, exactly where we thought it should be. So that at least will give them a little bit of a cushion. Now watch it again and listen for the whistle and look at the clock and the timeout call.
It looks like the whistle and the four is probably right. I'm surprised that we come out to play and then after the timeout was called and went back, and is, would that be an interesting thing?
Well, trust me, nobody came over to look at the replays, so you don't have to worry about it.
And that's one thing. Well, they've got a standby official over there. One of his jobs is to check the clock in these kind of situations. That may be the individual they went to who made the decision. But again, I'm surprised that we came up to put the ball in play and the timeout was called, that it wasn't corrected before that.
Our thanks to NCAA Basketball Committee Representative Ken Free and Tournament Manager Ken Hudgens, along with Tournament Media Coordinator Lou Herring here. I'm John Sanders, along with Gary Thompson. 72-71 Oklahoma. They led only twice here in the last few seconds of the game. Other than that, it's been all East Tennessee State, up by as many as 17, led by 8 at halftime. But slowly but surely, and thanks in good part, I think, to the play of William Davis and Mookie Blaylock in the second half, the Sooners have gotten back in it.
That's right. Davis inside. They went the inside game. He's real strong. Had a key follow shot of his own miss and put it back in. It was really important. There you see the timeouts left.
Well, twice before, when everybody is reset, the Sooners have called timeout. Let's see if we're going to play this time with 4 seconds to go. We are.
Tough place to get the pass right there.
There's the shot.
Got a piece of it. And the Sooners escape.
Exactly right. Oklahoma will move on to play Louisiana Tech. A squeaker. Stacy King, a strong ball game. 28 points for the All-American. Mookie Blaylock with 15. William Davis with 14. Handshakes at half court. A strong effort for East Tennessee State. The Buccaneers and Oklahoma played it well on the inbound play.
Well, they got Bell, their best leaper there. I think you got to try if you can to get that pass up court, because look at the time he eat up. 1 second to play and he's taking a 35-footer.
It was a squeaker for the Sooners, but they win it. For Gary Thompson, I'm John Sanders, saying so long from Memorial Gym in Nashville, Tennessee. It's Oklahoma 72, East Tennessee State 71. This has been an